So Mahatma Gandhi used to call himself the child of Bhagavad Gita. Quite radical to say, but interesting. And then, I don't know if it is true or not, but I read it somewhere that somebody asked Mahatma Gandhi that, tell us what is the philosophy of life within 5 words. And Mahatma Gandhi replied within 3 words that renounce and enjoy. Renounce and enjoy. He says this is the essence of Vedanta or Bhagavad Gita. I don't know if it is true, but sounds very interesting. Renounce and enjoy. So Bhagavad Gita is very clear about what is the renunciation and what it means to be renouncing, right? Because it is something very easy to be misunderstood. And it makes it very clear what exactly it is. So let's go into what does it mean by renouncing according to Bhagavad Gita. So it says, the Krishna says that there are 3 kinds of action that nobody should ever renounce. These are referred as yajna, tapa and dana, sacrifice, austerity and dana, right? So sacrifice here is more in terms of everybody has something to offer in the nature, right? If you take a look at the tree offers the fruits, right? So everything in the nature offers something to the nature in some way or another, right? The same way you also have some offering to do, right? So the yajna, in my understanding, means that whatever you are offering to the nature, right? It could be your work or one way or another, you will have to offer something, right? So that is referred as a yajna, your offering, your sacrifice. Sacrifice may not be the right word here, but it meant in that sense, in my understanding. Tapa means austerity. It literally means burning, right? So something which is uncomfortable, right? It could be as simple as, staying silent when things are coming up, right? Or working through your impurities, purifying yourself, right? So these kind of things are referred as a tapa. And dana is donation, charity. So these actions, Krishna is saying, under no circumstances anybody should ever, renounce them. And they should be done with no fruit in the mind, right? So this is another thing in Bhagavad Gita. If you kind of do an X-ray of Bhagavad Gita, probably this teaching of renounce the fruit of the action is going to be there most of the time. Yeah. So what Krishna is saying, you should be performing these 3 actions. You should never renounce these 3 actions with no fruit in the action in the mind. No fruit of the action in the mind. Yeah. And these actions even purify the greatest of the greatest. Yeah. Purify the Mahatmas or something like that. So they have like a very strong purification effect on you. So you never renounce them and do them without some kind of fruit, some kind of expectation of the fruit. Then he classified these renunciation in 3 types, sattvic, tamasic, rajasic. The sattvic is more correct way of doing it. Rajasic is not so correct way of doing it. And tamasic is just delusional, right? So he starts with tamasic. He says, the person should never renounce his duties, right? So in order to survive in the world, you will have to do something. You have to bring value in some way or another. So you can think of that as your duty in the world, right? Or if you have some dependent people, and you should be, and the condition is such that you need to take care of them. For example, you have a child. So you should never renounce your duty in that sense. And if somebody renounces out of delusion, like these kind of actions, it's referred as a tamasic. It's kind of a delusional renunciation, and it's going to be very harmful for the person. So it's very clear that nobody should ever just like leave all the things together and just move out somewhere to, do something strange. And these, Krishna is definitely not calling that as a renunciation, it's calling that as a delusion. Okay. The second one is rasik. This is where he says, a person is trying to renounce the action because it's hard, it's difficult, right? Things are not working out in the world, right? So we have seen this many times in our life, right? Because things are not so easy to come together. And because it's hard, because it's uncomfortable, because it is painful, if somebody is trying to renounce action because of these reasons, they are referred as a rasik renunciation, and they will lead to dukkha, they will lead to suffering, and there will be no fruit of renunciation for that person, right? So not renouncing because something is uncomfortable, right? Because your job is uncomfortable, your relationship is uncomfortable, you just want to leave them. So that kind of renunciation doesn't bring any kind of meaningful fruit. In fact, it is going to bring suffering. Then the third kind of the renunciation is what Krishna has called sattvic renunciation. What he is referring here, what he is saying is, the person who does his duties, whatever is the task assigned to him, without any kind of hatred or aversion towards it, when a person does do his duties and let go of the fruit of the action, that kind of a renunciation is called sattvic renunciation, right? That renouncing the fruit of the action, renouncing this expectations from the action, is referred as a sattvic renunciation. Now this does not, it might sounds like, then how would I be successful, right? If I renounce the fruit of the action and all that, how will I be successful? And actually the chances are, the probability is higher for you to be successful if you renounce and then act. But then here again, important thing to understand, this is all working in towards internal harmony, right? These teachings are mostly about how do you get to the state of mind which is higher, right? And from that state, whatever you do is going to be, much higher quality, as well as there are fruits which are going to be much more beautiful than anything else you do. But even then, this is where the Mahatma Gandhi is saying, Mahatma Gandhi is not doing something small, right? He's running the campaign for the freedom of a country, right? The millions of people is following him. And this is what he's saying. Renounce and rejoice, or renounce and enjoy, right? It's very hard to do something when we are attached, so difficult, right? The kind of a state of mind it creates, it's not very easy. Very crude example could be, you care so much about a job, and then you go in an interview and you will see like how you are going to perform about it, right? You will feel very nervous, you will feel very uncomfortable. On the other hand, you want to have that job, but you just don't care so much about the fruit of the action. And see what is going to happen in that interview, for example, right? You're going to be more comfortable, you're going to put out your best self, and the chances and probability is higher that whatever you're doing, you're going to be more successful in that. But the teaching here is that, that somebody who is doing his duty without the fruit of the action, without the attachment to the fruit of the action, is the highest kind of renunciation. And then he says, that look, Arjuna, this it is not possible for a human being to renounce all the actions. It's just not possible. But the person who renounced the fruit of the action is called the real renunciant, right? The person who is renouncing the fruit of the action is called the real renunciant, not the person who is trying to renounce the action, because that act of renouncing the action itself is action, right? So there, it's impossible. You cannot sustain your body without doing some action, right? So what he's saying, do your action, whatever is your duty, but renounce the fruit of the action. And that renunciation is called the sattvic renunciation. And for that person, he doesn't care so much about, I like to do this and I don't like to do this, kind of a kushal and akushal karma. He's okay with agreeable or disagreeable action, right? But if he really doesn't care about the fruit of the action, he's comfortable doing both, right? Something that he likes to do and something he doesn't like to do. It doesn't matter so much for that kind of a person, right? And for that person, when you act, there's going to be the fruit of the action, and the fruit of the action is going to be of three kinds. Either it's going to be something that you wanted, or something that you didn't want it, or something kind of a mix. And this kind of a person who is renunciant, he is comfortable with all three, right? And then his state of mind is kind of a peaceful and higher, right? So this is what Krishna meant by renunciation, and this is what he's teaching about renunciation. And the one important thing to take away from it, this kind of a renunciation, like leaving all the things and move somewhere else, is not a good idea altogether, according to Krishna, right? Also, this kind of renunciation, because things are hard and difficult and uncomfortable, leaving them is not a renunciation, right? But renouncing the fruit of the action and doing your work, whatever is the work is assigned to you, is a real renunciation.